are gathered here this afternoon in the presence of God to remember and celebrate promises made and promises kept, and to give thanks for the faithfulness of God throughout all the years. As seasons change and year follows year, the presence of God remains constant. In this is our hope, not that we have loved God, but that God has loved us first. Today, we celebrate that on September 30th, in the year of our Lord, 1960, 58 years ago, Nicholas and Nicole came before God and were properly buried according to laws of the state of New York, and they spoke words pledging their love and their loyalty, promising to each other a commitment to live a life of love together. Now they invite us as family to surround them with their love and support as they reaffirm their vows and their intention to continue to live in faithfulness to God and to one another. So let us pray. Holy and gracious God, you surround and uphold us in every moment of life. You give us family and friends for the journey, making our lives more abundant than we could ever ask or imagine. We give thanks for such enduring relationships. We thank you especially for the love and faithfulness that Nicholas and Nicole share. As they reaffirm promises made so long ago, give fresh grace to them for the years ahead. By the power of your Holy Spirit, bless their memories and strengthen their hopes that they may overflow in Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, Nicholas and Nicole, could I have you stand for just one moment? Just a moment. You have heard how God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage. Now, in the presence of God and these witnesses, do you wish to reaffirm the vows of Christian marriage? If you do, please say, we do.
We do.
You can be seated. For the members of the family now, please stand. Come on, everybody. We want you to stand.
You're family.
You are family. I now pose this question to the members of the family. Do you give your blessing to these two and promise to do everything in your power to continue to uphold them in their marriage? Do you?
Definitely.
You may be seated. We're going to hear the words of scripture that you've chosen, but first, let's pray. Your faithfulness to your covenant, O God of mercy, frees us to live together in the security of your powerful love. Amid all the changing words of our generation, speak your eternal word that does not change. Then may we respond to your gracious promises by living in faith and obedience to Christ our Lord. Now, Nick and Nicole have chosen two passages of scripture that are very meaningful to them. This one in particular, which is the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And the second one, that was from the Old Testament. This second one comes from the New Testament, and it's from the Apostle Paul. It's known as the love chapter. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we only know in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly. Then we will see face to face. Now I only know in part. Then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, the greatest of these is love. The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of God abides to Israel. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. I have a short homily I want to share with you this afternoon. It's not morning anymore. It's a bit of a challenge as a pastor to know what to share in the way of wisdom or insight at the renewal of vows for a couple that's been happily married for already 58 years. I've barely been alive that long. And Nick and Nicole are the ones with all the wisdom. But there is always a place and a necessity to share the wisdom of the word of the Lord, which is a privilege and an honor on a celebratory occasion like this. And I thank you for that. The purpose of hearing God's word is to hear of relationships of love, and that's exactly what God desires of us. As a couple settles into a routine in the beginning, making a home for themselves, it helps to know what the rules of play are. Compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, forgiveness, peace, and love. It helps to know what's expected. And those words I just read came from the Apostle Paul. And then our practical directives, which I know the two of you know well. They're important for individuals. They are important for couples. They're absolutely imperative for the Church of Jesus Christ. And it's interesting that the unifying power of the love of Christ is the unifying power for all love relationships. What we learn is that the love of God is manifested in us when we love one another. And it's in us because the very essence of God is love. God is love, and love is God. And how precious the gift of Jesus was and is to teach us about the love in real life and what it means and what it really involves. The Word of God is precious because it is preserved from generation to generation, and the years come and the years go, and the grass withers, and the flowers fall, but God's Word stands forever. For us to presume, though, that every day of every week, of every month, of every year is going to be a stress-free walk in the park would just be foolish. There are plenty of beautiful days, and we celebrate those, and thanks be to God for that, but there are also those days and times when we are walking through those dark moments. And because of the love of God that dwells in us, we know that we will not dwell forever in those places. One of my favorite pieces of scripture says, "Our help cometh from the Lord who made heaven and earth." The Lord shall preserve our souls, our going out, our coming in from this day forth, and even forevermore, for 58 years, and for 59 years, and for 60 years, and for who knows how long. We know who to turn to. And it is in this turning and turning and turning again, as we grow and mature and have children and grandchildren, we continue to turn to God and to depend on God, and our lives are sustained Whomever therefore God has joined together, let no man be asunder. Okay, now I'm going to have y'all renew your marriage vows now. Can you stand for just a few moments?
Yes.
Okay, just a few moments. I'm going to ask you this one compound question. Do you, Nicholas, promise before God and these witnesses to continue to be Nicole's loving and faithful husband in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as you both shall live? Do you? If you do, say, I do.
I do.
All righty then. We're going to give Nicole a chance now, but I'm going to still hold your hand. I give you now this one long compound question. Do you promise before God and these witnesses? Well, I'll try to hold hands. Oh, I think that would be nice. Do you promise before God and these witnesses to continue to be Nicholas's loving and faithful wife in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as you both shall live? Do you? You do. Do you want to exchange your rings?
Take them off.
You hand yours to her, and you hand yours to him. I'm going to let you sit down now. I don't want you to have to stand too long. Okay. All right, you have yours. Will you just switch? Can you get your ring off? You know what? If not, we can just do yours.
Yeah. Would you believe you need windows?
Try to lick.
Okay.
Yeah, you just stick it in your mouth.
Lick his fingers.
This is actually the original. Is it that he had lost his? So this is mine is the original.
Oh, that is beautiful. Okay.
This has NB.
What's
NB? September 30th, 1960. Love. Mine doesn't have love.
Oh. That's very sweet. All right, I want you to sit next to Nick and hold hands. All right. Now, I'm going to ask Nick if he's giving you this ring. I'm going to ask you to say, I do it again, okay?
Yes.
All right. Do you give this ring as a sign of your love?
Yes.
Reaffirm this day in tender hope for what lies ahead in the name of God, whose steadfast love endures forever. Do you please say yes?
Yes.
Now you take your ring and put it on. And can you help her put her ring on?
Yes.
There we go. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Can you put that on her finger? There we go.
Right.
Right there. All right. Super. Good job. All right, let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world you've made and redeemed, and especially upon Nick and Nicole. As you accompanied our ancestors, so you journey with us to our life's end, where we will enjoy life abundant in your eternal realm. We give you thanks today that we stand in the company of the faithful, grateful recipients of your steadfast love. Bless Nick and Nicole in their life together. May they continue to grow in mutual love, take care of one another, practice patience, and set a table of hospitality, and be lifted in joy, all in service to your coming reign. Grant that we, who have witnessed this reaffirmation of vows, may find our own promise renewed and our faith strengthened, so that in joy and in love, we may continue the journey set before us with courage and hope. May our own lives bear witness to the grace we have received from you, God, our present, past, and future. Grant that the bonds by which all your children are united to one another may so be transformed by your Spirit that your peace and justice may fill the earth through Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is Nick and Nicole, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves in compassion, kindness, and patience, forgiving each other as the Lord has forgiven you, and crown all these things with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And now, may the grace of Christ attend you. May the love of God surround you. May the Holy Spirit keep you, that you may live in faith, abound in hope, and grow in love both now and forevermore. Alleluia, alleluia, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Nicholas and Nicole, Mr. and Mrs. Gravardi. You may kiss the bride.
Thank you.
bestow